Well, good evening. You're here at St. Ignatius, and it is Advent. We are so delighted you're here. This is going to be a very special evening, the first of our Christmas concerts. You're in for a very, very special treat. Jonah Kim and the Christmas Trio. My name is Franca. On behalf of our pastor, Father Greg Bonfilio, our wonderful parish family, and our parish staff team, we are so happy you are here and starting out your Advent season with us. Before we get into this evening's program and I introduce you to our wonderful artists, I want to share with you a fun game. So as far as I know, the live chat has been enabled for the concert this evening, and you're able to type in your comments. We'd love to hear from you. Tell us what kind of music you like to hear in the future. Give us some thoughts. But one thing I'm going to ask is you participate in a little contest. So this is going to get us ready for our concert next week, which is our children and family concert. So I'm hoping that there are a few children in the audience or children at heart who will be able to do this. So our contest this evening is, you see this beautiful, beautiful altar. And on the top of the altar are some angels. Well, it's Christmas. We have lots of angels around us all year round, but they're especially prevalent this time of year. So what I'd like you to do is try to count them. And we were very fair. We're just going to ask you to count the angels on the top row, because those are relatively visible with the camera and the live stream. The ones that are on the second row above the doors are difficult, and some are hidden, so we don't want to make it difficult for folks. And in the live stream, in the live chat, give us your answer. How many angels are on that top row here above the altar? And give us your answer. Let us give me your name, and later at the end of the show, Pat will flash my email on the screen, and you just email me your answer if you were not able to put it in the live chat, and we have some very special prizes to send out to folks. So, I don't want to spend any more time on that. I want you to hear these exemplary performers, and I want to tell you a little bit about them. So, first off, and he is coming back for, I think, his third performance here at St. Ignatius, we are so delighted to have Jonah Kim. Grammy Award-winning artist Jonah Kim made his solo debut with Wolfgang Sawalich and the Philadelphia Orchestra in 2003. He has since performed on the world's most prestigious stages. As a highly sought-after chamber musician, Jonah has collaborated with Van Cliburn competition winner John Nakamatsu, Elmar Oliveira, Chi-Yung Kim, Yuja Wang, and leading members of the world-class ensembles such as Orpheus New Century and the Guarneri and Tokyo Quartets. Jonah pairs his 1845 J.B. Vuillaume cello with a bow made in 1904 by Jules Fatique in Paris. Look for his August 2020 album release of Rachmaninoff and Barber Cello Sonatas on Delos, the great American label. And I will tell you now, for those of you who enter the contest and win, we will be sending you one of Jonah's recent CDs. Allegra, our pianist, described as brilliant by the San Francisco Classical Voice, San Francisco-based pianist and presenter, Allegra Chapman is dedicated to connecting deeply with audiences. Allegra has performed as a soloist and chamber musician at prestigious venues throughout the US, Europe, and China, including Alice Tully Hall, the Dam Mira Hess Memorial Concert Series, the Bard Music Festival, the Liszt Ferenc Memorial Museum in Budapest, San Francisco Jazz Center, and Cheyenne Concert Hall in Cheyenne, China. And our violinist. Dennis Kim has been concertmaster of Pacific Symphony since September 2018. A citizen of the world, Dennis was born in Korea, raised in Canada, and educated in the United States. He has spent more than a decade learning orchestras in the United States, leading orchestras in the United States, Europe, and Asia. Most recently, he was concertmaster of the Buffalo Philharmonic Orchestra in New York. He was the first appointed concertmaster of the Tucson Symphony Orchestra at the age of 22. He then served as the youngest concertmaster in the history of the Hong Kong Philharmonic Orchestra before going on to lead the Seoul Philharmonic Orchestra and then Tampere Philharmonic Orchestra in Finland. I hope I pronounced that right. As guest concertmaster, Kim has performed on four continents, leading the BBC Symphony Orchestra, London Philharmonic Orchestra, Royal Stockholm Philharmonic Orchestra, and many, many others. A dedicated teacher, he has served on the faculty at the Royal Conservatory of Music in Toronto and Prisma Festival and the Interlaken Center for the Arts, among others. He is a graduate of the Curtis Institute of Music and the Yale School of Music. Now, with all of these biographies, I was very much chagrined because, in the interest of time, I had to do some serious editing. But just know that all of these artists have phenomenal backgrounds, and we will post more later on our website and our live feed that have their extended biographies if you would like to look at them. Again, thank you for being with us, and I'm going to turn it over to the Christmas Trio.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for having us back. back at St. Ignatius. It's really a pleasure to be back. It's been a while since the last one, so I must say that in the beginning, we were feeling a little bit rusty. Thank you for bearing with us. Actually, we're just kidding. We wanted to do that because actually when we made the arrangement, we've been working on these for a while, actually, and we just thought it would be really nice to get back in touch with like that childhood feeling of when we were first learning to play the instrument. And of course, you know, we wanted to have fun with it too. I hope you had fun with the hymn, and I don't know how many trivia questions we get, but if you could go on the live chat and take a few guesses as to what pop song we decided to mash that up with. I think it's pretty obvious though, right? So much fun, we have a lot of fun. We've been working on a few of these, and tonight we hope to share a couple more with you. The next piece we're gonna share with you is a beautiful slow movement by, it's an Andante movement by Schubert. And for me, Schubert is one of my favorite composers, but also this particular movement for me has a feeling almost like, you know, the Christmas song, I'll Be Home for Christmas. It's kind of like that kind of feeling, and I thought that it would be really appropriate to share this melody with you. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
favorite movements by Schubert. The next piece I hope you all recognize. Dennis didn't because I think it's the wrong generation. Too young, right? I'm not going to tell you what it is, but if you want to get a little bit competitive and see who can identify what the song is on the live chat first, can I promise a prize, or am I not allowed to do that? I'm going to promise you a prize anyway. Yes, that's right. Christmas time is here. We wish you a happy Christmas. And we have a few more songs for you, so don't go away yet. The next piece we're going to play, we're going to go back to a little bit more of the music that we actually went to school to learn instead of started arranging for fun on our own. I know, we can play the fun stuff all night, but also we want you to buy our album when we finally put it out. So we're not going to play you every single song, maybe another couple, you know. But the next piece we're going to play is the first movement of the D minor trio by Mendelssohn. If there are Korean people out there in the parish, you know, we add an extra syllable. We call him Mendelssohn. I don't know where the extra J comes from, but somewhere when he got imported to the Far East, he gained a letter. So that letter's in my name. Let's see. I like this piece, and it reminds me of Christmas because... have you ever seen like Valkurgisnacht? How do you say that in English? Yeah. How do you say that in English? What does it mean in English again? It's like the Grinch sort of, but not really. It's like a little bit more fairy tale like than that. But for me, it's like a journey, and there's like these really beautiful moments of oasis and. It's just one of my favorite pieces, so I hope you enjoy it, and I hope that you can let your imagination run wild and come along for a very fun adventure with three of us. Thanks. Thank you. And of course, now I think of it, The Nightmare Before Christmas. That's what I think of when I listen to this piece. So something a little lighter after that. I think we've earned it. Let's see. The Light at the End of the Tunnel. How about Amazing Grace? That's a song that we all know and love. We decided to go a very special route with this, and we decided to give it a little bit extra sauce. Because grace is like that, and at least in my life, it feels like sauce. It's like the good part, you know, because all the rest of it, like, it could be anything. You know, it could be chicken, it could be beef. The sauce is the important part. So the sauce for this is jazz, and we think it's very compatible, grace and jazz. But we'd like to know what you think, and we'd love to read your thoughts on the live chat. Thanks. Hope you enjoy. I hope you enjoyed that. That's one of my favorite charts, and we just love playing that so much. We just have a few more minutes, and so we thought we'd play a couple more songs for you. We haven't done very much loud and fast. Actually, yes, we have. What am I talking about? But we have more loud and fast for you, and then maybe another song. I don't know. What about some Shostakovich? We're going to play you the fast frenzy dance from the second movement of the second piano trio.
Work really hard on that one. It's like a workout with a mask.
Thank you for watching our incredible workout just then. I think I burned like all the calories I ate at dinner. And now, without further ado, my favorite chart in the entire program, because this is, I think, the best way for me to think about Jesus. What a friend. Like a friend you'd never had before, you know? It's like the genie song. I love it. That's my Jesus right there. So I hope that you enjoy the concert. And on this very friendly, casual note, let's just enjoy Jesus and all the grace we have through the holidays this year, because really, what else do we got, right? But we're very blessed, I think, that we get to, I don't know, still share this time together, share this life together. We're still here, and there's so much beauty, and there's so much goodness, and there's so much love in the world that I think it's worth fighting for. I think it's worth getting up the next day. I think it's worth getting together and, I don't know, taking a few extra COVID tests so we can, you know? But and wearing masks, too. I think it's all worth it. And so I want to thank every one of you for signing on tonight and for inviting us to be here. We really love sharing our art, our music, with all of you, our friends, our family, and your support, and that you care, it means everything to us. So thank you very much, and we leave you with "What a Friend We Have in Jesus."
What a concert. What a gift. What a gift. Thank you so much for being here this evening.
Our pleasure. Thank you.
Well, to all of you, you couldn't hear their applause, but I know there were folks applauding at home, snuggled up on their sofa. We had a winner. Laurel, thank you very much. You were the closest. I did get a couple emails. And I got some on chats, but Laurel, you were the closest at 18. They're actually on the top row. They're 14 angels. So, Pat, if you will go ahead and flash my email on the screen, send me your snail mail address, and we will send you Jonah's latest recording. Thank you. Thank you for participating. And I hope you all had a lot of fun. We certainly did. I hate to say goodbye to these beautiful artists. They'll be back. We'll figure out how and when. So watch our website. I will tell you next week Our winter series continues. That's our family and children's concert, and we will also have some interesting contests and games going on next Thursday. Special treat, we have scenes from the Nutcracker. I'm not going to give away any surprises. You'll just have to tune in and see. And after the Nutcracker, we will be doing a concert edition of A Christmas Carol. And again, without giving away any surprises, we have a very special person doing Scrooge. I don't know if it's his theatrical debut. I don't know a whole lot, but we were delighted when he accepted the offer to play the part of Scrooge. So please, next week, tune in. And do remember that if you go to our YouTube channel, you can also see past concerts, and we will be posting this concert, this evening's concert, on the channel. So if you missed it or you know friends who missed it, just tell them to check out the channel anytime. And again, to all of you, thank you so much. May your start of Advent be filled with wonder and beauty and lots of joy. And we will see you again. Thank you. And Jonah and the Christmas Trio, thank you again.